We're here with head women's track and field coach Amy Horst, heading into the MAAC championships this weekend. Coach, how's it been the past couple of weeks in competition? You had a nice couple of results at the Lions Invitational, encouraging heading into this weekend.
Yeah, we did. The Lions Invitational was great for us. Some of our athletes actually had competed 2 days prior to that. Christina Krupa was one of them. She competed in the DMR at Penn Thursday night and ran a really nice split in the four. Ran the 4x2 again at Penn on Friday and then was racing yet again on Saturday. So we're really encouraged. She's taking some rest this week. But she was really ready to go. Courtney Morrow had some awesome times, just dropping like crazy at the Lions. So we really saw our sprint side come together and perform and really have some nice marks. The 4x4 had the fastest time they've had of the entire year. And so after all of that they had done, it was encouraging to see them still be able to put those times out and really race and compete.
Those two in particular, Courtney Morrow and Christina Krupa, have just competed very well for you, dropping their times consistently throughout the year. Who are some other people who are on the radar to score some points for you at MAAC?
We'll be looking, Courtney Williford, call her Fresh. She'll be very excited to know that I've called her that. It's her nickname. In the javelin, she's really been coming around, just starting to throw. And I'd say, for the most part, is that kind of a very basic level of throwing in the jab, but really having success, and so we're looking for her to score some points for us. Tori Savinsky in the steeple came out in her very first steeple at the Colonial Relays back in the end of April at Williamsburg, shattered the school record. And what a lot of people don't know, the first time she ever went over a water barrier was in the race. kind of coached her in her warm-up about how to take on the water barrier. She said, okay, I can do that. And she went in and did that. So we're looking for her and Steph Gibney to score some points there. Looking for some points on the long distances in the 5K and 10K. Steph, again, is going to come back and do the double. Amanda Bossy, Emily Rooney, some of the ladies in there, and then looking in our mid-distance crew to try and get after and break into the Iona contingent in the 1500 and in the 800. Also looking for trying to steal some points maybe out of the 4 and 2, take advantage of us. We compete. That's what we know how to do. We just go in and say, okay, we're having the meet today because it's not done and over. So one of the big things I talk about the women with is don't give someone the place. Don't automatically, just because they've run faster than you in the past, give them the place in that race today. That's why we're out there racing right now. So in the 2 and the 4, we're going to go into it looking for those points, even though we're sitting well out of the scoring positions right now.
You also have some good senior leadership on your team. Tell me a little bit about the seniors who are going to be competing in their last MAAC championships this weekend.
Sure. Alyssa Doyle is one of them. She has never actually run two consecutive track seasons back-to-back, so she ran indoor and as outdoor. She's a senior, which is crazy. This is actually her first indoor season that she completed. She's actually had 6 stress fractures in her life, so getting her to this point is really outstanding. Handling her training, she's been a trooper, and so she's in the pool for the 4x8. That's going to open the meet on Saturday, and we'll be racing in the 15 on Sunday. Amanda Bossy is going to be coming in and seeing what she can make happen in that 10K. We want to make a legitimate race out of it Saturday night. Courtney in the, is going to be running the 2, the 100 hurdles. And, you know, we've already mentioned she's just been, she's a wild card in my opinion, that she could just really step up, and if all goes well, she'll be racing even faster yet because if she follows her trend. Sarah Oakes will be racing in the 15. And Angeline Diamond is going to be in the, probably in the 2, and then we'll be looking for her in the hammer. She was originally a sprinter. When she got injured, started doing some throwing, basically doing some lifting, playing around with some throwing, and found out she had some success there. And so we'll see what she can do. And then also Paige Godfrey in the 100. She'll be helping us out in the short sprints in the 100 and the 4x1.
Coach, thanks a lot, and good luck this weekend.
Thank you.